So I'm joined here today by Lloyd Russell-Moyle, MP for Brighton Kemp Town, for this episode of the Vote. We're going to start off, got a lot to get through. Black Lives Matter, the campaign, it's in Brighton, it's a national campaign. It obviously started off in America. What are your thoughts on it?
Well, I think it's really interesting. It's not, of course, the first time that there have been protests, or even protests saying Black Lives Matters. And it's not the first time in the US that there's been a death because the police have decided to murder someone in front of the public, which is what happened. Let's be very clear, that was murder, and that's what the police are going to be charged with. But I think what's different this time is that there is a real feeling that there's enough is enough, can't continue anymore, and there is a real feeling from people that after many years of not seeing progress, that we need to push to make sure this is a lasting thing. And it's not just about the US, where we know policing's completely messed up in the USA. Thousands of different police forces, different regulations, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Far too much. But also here in the UK, Sussex Police is not immune to having instances of racism in their police force. I mean, no police force is in Britain. It's not that Sussex Police Force is bad or worse or better. And many people of colour talk about how they feel victimised by how authorities treat them. I think here in this city, we've got a very good council, but even sometimes how council policies play out and people apply policies has meant that I've seen it where people of colour, black people in particular, have ended up being victimised. I'm pleased that the city has agreed to start to review things like street names and statues.
Yeah. Where do you think we will go with that review that Nancy Platt's council leader asked for? But I mean, we have the big statues. Obviously, Queen Victoria's a big one, isn't it? That we're all thinking of Grand Avenue. There's also a bust at Clock Tower. But because this is it's stirred up a big debate, hasn't it? This nationally, isn't it? The whole statue debate. I mean, do you see Churchill Square being renamed, for example? Or, I mean, where do you?
Well, look, I think that we have to. It's a discussion and we have to take things case by case.
Yeah.
And I don't think we should just be seeing this as something abnormal. Throughout all time, people have moved statues because they want them to be more prominent or less prominent. You erect statues and you take them down. That's very usual. It was done, and that's been done for hundreds of years in this country. And so for us to constantly be reviewing what statues we want to be most prominent and where they need to be and the placing of them, that's a perfectly reasonable thing to be doing. And also to be talking about what text needs to be associated with those statues to reflect what we know that person was. The rule of thumb for me would be, but it's not me that will make the decision, it's a conversation that needs to happen with the community. But the rule of thumb for me would be, if the statue there just glorifies someone or their actions, and their primary actions were around slave trade, promoting racism and xenophobia and those kinds of things, they're primary actions, and that statue is then celebrating that or whitewashing it, pretending it didn't really happen, then those are troubling statues that probably should be moved into places where they can be seen in better context.
Yeah.
And if they are a statue where there's someone who is imperfect, but did some good things and did some bad things or had some troubling views as well, then I think that there is a more complicated discussion, and it's more about how do you put that statue in context. And it still might be that you move the statue because you might decide that it's better placed somewhere else. But sculptures and statues have existed for a long time in this city, and they have been moved very regularly in this city. The sculptures and statues on Victoria Gardens have been moved, all of them, numerous times. Some of the statues outside the Royal Pavilion have been moved a number of times. You know, the idea that statues are permanent is not true and has never been true.
What do you think about the longer-term prospects, then, for the Black Lives Matter campaign? Do you think that we're going to see action at a national level?
Well, I hope we...
Or is it too early to tell?
Well, I do. I mean, your viewers don't know. I mean, you could broadcast these, but every Thursday I do a public Zoom meeting where I get guests in and I do a little presentation with them. I'm more than happy for you to broadcast it on latest if you wanted.
Yes.
They're all, I put them on YouTube. And yesterday I did one on Black Lives Matter. And one of the big conversations that readers, you know, constituents were writing into me about, and we had the panellists talking about, was education. And whether we think that education needs to change, and whether we need to talk about our history better, and who needs to deliver that. Is it just your stuffy history teacher, or should people of colour, should, if you're talking about gay history, gay people, should, if you're talking about women's history, should it be women, should they also be part of delivering it? And I think that they should be, although the discussion was that it shouldn't, the burden shouldn't just all be on BAME people and black people. Yeah. It should be on numerous, all people to have to get up to speed. And I also thought that the good discussion was that no one is saying that teachers or the curriculum has deliberately necessarily been racist. Sometimes it might have been, but broadly. A lot of the time it's that many people feel shameful about our history. And because they feel shameful, they don't talk about it. Because it was a shameful history. I mean, not talking about it, it seems like you're covering it up. And actually what you need to do when you do something wrong is not just be quiet about it, but you need to own up to it.